ब्रह्मचर्य व्रती दंडी सर्ववेदांत कंठित श्रीमद् विवेक योगी माम प्रचोदयतु सर्वदा. सो वी हैव टू टेक इंस्पिरेशन फ्रॉम दिस शिकागो लेक्चर. वट एवर इज टू बी स्टडीड और अंडरस्टूड कॉम्प्रहेंडेड made practical in our lives, they have all been contained in that small lecture, 2-3 minutes lecture of Swamiji. So the picture of India, how we should love India, we should start seeing the whole world as our family, that Rujina Vaichitriya, because it is necessary for us in Indians, because people are always trying to divide us in the name of states now, religion now, culture, language. That is a man's habit. He looks for differences than unity. That is his habit itself. So when everywhere everybody is trying to create this sort of a division, Veda Bhava, to get into ourselves a Abheda Bhava, to absorb that Advaita vision of Swamiji, his practical Vedanta, his glorifying India as mother, his glorifying Sanatana Dharma as a great contribution of Mother India to the world, as a Vasudeva Kudumbam, etc., we have to understand that. You know, sometime back, when I was thinking of leaving my job and going to Vivekananda Kendra, I met that great teacher, Swami Rangadadhanandaji. So he told me, Lakshmi, the whole society today is like a leper's body. Everywhere you find, you will find wounds, pus, blood, decaying tissues. But that is not to be the future of India. India has to regenerate. She has to revitalize herself. So what is needed? At least here and there, there should be vital living tissues. I want you to be a living tissue wherever you are. You may be in a scientific laboratory, you may be a teacher, you may be in the house, wherever it may be, try to be a living tissue. So, through this Love India channel, what we are trying to convey is, see, we cannot afford to make India die. We have to restore her back to her glory. For that, each one of us will have to be a living tissue. When will the tissue be living? Because it's the habit of the tissue to go on dying. It will have disease, it will have decay, and it will die. But if you touch something eternal within you, something which has no destruction, no decay, no death, if that is there within you, then you are saved. That point will live. See, all these bacteria, the virus, how do they live? They don't die. Because they are centered in that life point. That is all they have. They don't have any decaying tissues around them, like what we have, muscles, blood, etc. So that central point, that eternal self within us, it is that has to be understood. That has to be promoted. That has to be made part and parcel of our life. And then what happens? We ourselves become alive, alive with life, alive with understanding, alive with knowledge, alive with, in Swamiji's words, Tyaga and Seva, through which we can execute Mother's will. We should be, each one of us should be able to bring about that Advaita, that Abheda Bhava, that each one of us is Mother's child. Which mother? It could be great Mother India, or it could be that great Parashakti, whose glory the nature is singing all the time, through all the varieties, all the situations and all the events, good, bad, indifferent. We may think something is good, something is bad, something. No, everything is her play only. So to give that sort of an elevation, enlightenment to our mind, we have to absorb unto ourselves the great thought of Advaita. And in the here we sort of sort of conclude our Swamiji's thoughts on India as a living, spiritual, glorified entity. Now we shall see in the succeeding classes how Swamiji goes into the spirit of India, absorbs from her those wonderful items of life, living, and by which we can transform our lives into glorious. That is how he comes to the man-making, nation-building, character-building advices, values, by which each and every human being, wherever they are, we can become, in Guru's words, a living tissue. We are working in a place, yes, be good karma yogi. You are doing seva, yes, let the seva be motivated with tyaga. So we will see step by step, each and every concept in our life can be changed without hurting ourselves. That is Swamiji's beautiful contribution. You don't hurt yourself. By following Vivekananda's pattern of man-making, you don't hurt yourself nor others. So that is the wonderful Vivekananda literature. Now we shall enter into it by and by.